Today's video, we're going to dive into Notion Mail. I'm going to give you a first look into the application after playing around with it for a little bit of time. Now, it's currently available in a sort of like pre-launch beta, or at least, because they launched this thing where you can basically go into it and try and hack your way to the Easter eggs of getting access to this. It's sort of reminding me a bit of Severance, a bit of like old school email combined in one, but it's quite a cool way. Managed to get access through there, and I've been playing around with it for a few days now. Now, the application does allow you to sign in through Gmail, through Apple, and through Microsoft. So I'm not entirely sure what they have plans in terms of their third-party integrations, but I can imagine it's Outlook, Gmail, and iCloud to start things off. Now, I connected it with my Gmail, and this application wants you to remove your thinking of previous email apps. So the best place to start is to just jump in. Today's video is kindly sponsored by Zapier. If you're interested in Zapier, you can find it below and we'll talk about it later into this video. So I got my glasses on. We can now jump into the application. I can see it. So what's different about Notion Mail is that it looks a lot like Notion. And it really tries to take a lot of the same thesis that Notion really does well at. So the first thing of those is an area called views. Now, views can be designed around filters and sorting, a bit like you would with a database, but it can also be arranged around something called an auto label. Now, auto labels are essentially a prompt which you put in to narrow down your options. So in this case, it could be customer service inquiries, or I don't know, emails from my mum. I don't know. It could be very hyper specific. And whatever the term is, it'll help show that view only based on the prompt and searching your inbox. So it's a cool feature. It is being commonly done by other applications like Superhuman. I think Fixer are doing this as well. That is one of the first experiences, but you don't have to go off a prompt. If you're not prompt ready, you can use something called a template. And as you can see here, you've got a few different templates, and they've already provided a few. Like, for example, this one here is any emails that are internal, so keepproductive.com related ones from those email addresses, as a way to just consolidate all of your internal inbox. But they've also got some pretty neat ones like calendar, priority ones, so you can organize email by priority, and a few other ones like promotional and travel. Now, interestingly, what I quite like about this is, for example, I created an auto label earlier, and this is based on emails that contain the tag Carl, who is my co-founder, and does include the following in the mailboxes. But the one thing that you can do around this experience is actually edit the views in more detail, like you would a database. So you can go in here and you can modify the properties, moving them around, from moving where from is located, even whether you want to see all of this stuff. Obviously, you sort of have to see something or else it's pretty pointless. But this idea is allowing you to shape your inbox and how you want it to be viewed. You can also choose what command comes into play here as well. So if you were to hover over an item, you could choose this one and use the command bar. But you can modify all of the things that come up, which is pretty nice. So if you don't want reminders to show, if you want unsubscribe to show, that could be helpful if you've got a news or newsletters thing and you just want to quickly unsubscribe from stuff straight away. So this experience is designed to be approachable, like views are inside of Notion, and you can even modify the emoji if you did want to as well. So you can narrow down this inbox as well by using an auto label within it, which helps it further improve your recommendations. Ever wanted to automate things, but you lack the coding skills? You can now do that with Zapier with no code. Zapier is the leader in automation, allowing you to take your workflows to the next level with a suite of automation tools. You can go from an idea to reality in no time, setting up triggers for simple workflows and for even more advanced ones. That's why over 2.2 million companies use and trust Zapier. And thanks to Zapier for sponsoring this video. So I did this with a account security notification thing using auto label, and it was quite good at being able to give me an idea of any account security messages that were coming up, which is a helpful time saver, but I can imagine the possibilities are pretty endless with this. What is nice as well is you can change the icon on the left to be a bit more around the brand that are emailing you. For example, if you get GitHub emails, you could have a view for just that. So it helps you to narrow down your views there. So moving on, I think the second thing I want to show you is the creation of emails. And this works pretty well. So what it actually does is help you to write emails, but as if you were writing a Notion page. So here you can use your regular sort of slash command to essentially open up the Notion experience. And you can bring in snippets, which are essentially little templates you can use, like your Zoom link and things like that, which means you can save snippets for future. I'll come back to that in a bit. But I quite like the fact that you can use the headings like you would in Notion. You can use Markdown as well. And as you can see, I can start forming it like I was inside of Notion. Now down here, you can see that you can modify the email signature, but it works pretty much like you would anything in Notion. Now, one thing I really like is the block in here. Now, I didn't think it would work this well, but the block allows you to find a time with anybody else. So what's nice is it actually comes up with a window of your entire calendar in this really nice format. So you can go ahead and select a few dates, choose the conferencing software that you've decided to use. In my case, it's Google Meet, but you can also change the name of this, like meeting with Bob. And you can see the availability even skipping ahead as well to actually narrow down your choices. You can change the amount of time and you're pretty much good to go here. So I can go ahead and see this. And then if I click into it, I'll bring up all the options. You can see that it creates and generates this for you really nicely. So I love that the, I'm really impressed with the capability of scheduling in this really clean window. So I would recommend having a look at that if you're somebody that's really uber calendar orientated. Now coming back to those snippets, you can create a new snippet here, and snippets are essentially a way to basically save yourself time. So I could create a snippet called Finding Tools, and I could say, go to toolfinder.co to find new tools. And if I press save here, I can add attachments or whatever. If I press save and I press finding new tools, bang, it comes up quite easily like you would inside of Notion. So you can do attachments, you can do a scheduled send as well to a custom date. There's a few recommendations there. So there is a feature inside of reply email that'll help you to respond to the email faster. Now, this is actually something that is available as part of the Notion AI plan, and they're rolling this feature out. I'll show some demonstrations on screen. But I could ask, for example, draft an email reply to Ryan, and it'll use the AI to formulate that response. And as you can see, I can either accept it or deny it or modify it in more detail. Now, the one thing you can do is if you press space again, you can mention a certain workspace as well. So for example, if I wanted to mention a, I don't know, Nina's workspace, then I could have that there and the AI is going to read the page and be able to correspond to the replies. So if one of your team has left some notes on how to respond to Ryan, then you can reference that page and the AI can contextualize it and come back with a more accurate answer. So one of the things you can do is create auto labels on particular emails. So for example, if you've got an email and you want it to scan the email and work out which one is suitable for you, you can essentially label future emails with these type of things. And this is helpful because it's saving you the legwork of potentially bringing in potential opportunities for you, but labeling them in a way that is more suitable for you. So in this case, it's brought together a list of the sponsorships or collaborations that may be helpful for me. And I can go ahead and approve or deny some of them to help train the label for future emails. So obviously I'm not able to mention everything in this video in terms of all of the features, because it's like quite a tricky, complex application, email apps. But what I'm gonna do is show you what the settings look like. So you can set up a few different things with how your inbox works, like is there a centerpiece or full page, so you get that full Notion experience. You can also set up the auto labels from here if you want to, as well as Gmail filters. So if you have a Gmail filter that you want set up, you can have them for incoming emails. Here you can manage snippets and manage a signature, as well as manage your account as well, if you do find it suitable. Ooh, Notion Mail, an interesting layout. This is obviously a first look at Notion Mail, so it's not really something that we're happy to do a full review on just yet. We need more time to play with the features, but it gave you a little window into whether it's a suitable email app or whether it's even worth investing your time. An interesting setup at the moment, and a lot of email apps are moving to this more manageable, organized state for you. So a big, big thank you for stopping by on this video. If you did enjoy it, thumbs up, because it will help other people find the video. And if you're looking for more resources and tools, email apps, then jump over to toolfinder.co. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I look forward to helping you with more content.